A very good morning, friends. Today we will discuss about important hematopoietic vitamin, that is vitamin B12, and another name for vitamin B12 is cobalamin. We'll remember this vitamin B12 with this mnemonic, the important aspects of vitamin B12 with this mnemonic, that is cobamin MMS mega scam. I repeat, it is cobamin MMS mega scam. We'll discuss the important aspects of vitamin B12 with this mnemonic. The first one is it contains or it is a corine ring with central cobalt. Then the another name for cobalamin is vitamin B12. The active form of vitamin B12 is this adenosyl cobalamin, and second one is the methyl cobalamin. Then it requires intrinsic factor for the absorption in the ileum. It requires intrinsic factor for absorption in the ileum. Then the deficiency of this vitamin B12 lead to the various neurological symptoms or neurological manifestations. It is also known as extrinsic factor of Castle. Then it catalyzes three reactions. Of these, two are very important. The first one is the methyl malonyl CoA mutase, that is methyl malonyl coenzyme A mutase, and second one is the methionine synthase. Then deficiency leads to the megaloblastic anemia. And subacute combined degeneration of spinal cord. And deficiency leads to the excretion of methyl malonate in urine. So these are the important aspects about the vitamin B12. That is, it contains corine ring with central cobalt atom, also known as vitamin B12. Two coenzymes or two active forms, that is adenosyl cobalamin or methyl cobalamin. Then it requires intrinsic factor for absorption, and the main site for absorption is ileum. Deficiency leads to the neurological manifestation. The another name for cobalamin is extrinsic factor of Castle. Then two important reactions there. The first one is methyl malonyl coenzyme A mutase, and second one is the methionine synthase. Then deficiency leads to the megaloblastic anemia, subacute combined degeneration of the spinal cord, and leads to the methyl malonate excretion in urine, that is known as methyl malonic aciduria. Now coming to the important points about the vitamin B12. The first one is the digestion, absorption and transport of vitamin B12. In digestion, absorption and transport of vitamin B12, the first important point is the salivary gland secretes the important substance that is known as R binder. And the parietal cell, gastric parietal cells, secretes the intrinsic factor. These two factors are very important for digestion and absorption of vitamin B12. When we take dietary vitamin B12 with the action of HCl and pepsin, there is release of B12 in the stomach from the food. This B12 binds with the R binder in the stomach and transported up to the duodenum. This is in the stomach. This gets transported up to the duodenum, where with the action of proteases, this complex is broken down, and here this B12 get attached to the intrinsic factor, which is released by the gastric parietal cells. Now, when it reaches the ileum, in ileum there are special receptor for intrinsic factor. These receptors are known as cubulin receptors. These receptors are present on the ileal cell on the intestinal side. When this intrinsic factor and B12 reaches to the cubulin with the help of endocytosis, this complex get internalized
to the ileal mucosal cell, and from this cell it gets
to the portal circulation. Summarizing this digestion, absorption and transport, this R binder, it is secreted by the salivary gland. Intrinsic factor, it is secreted by the gastric parietal cells. With the action of HCl and pepsin, there is release of B12 from the food, and it get attached with the R binder in the stomach, get transported up to the duodenum. In the duodenum, it get attached with the intrinsic factor, and when it reaches the ileum, there is cubulin receptor. This intrinsic factor get attached to the cubulin receptor, and with the help of endocytosis, it get internalized into the ileal mucosal cells. Through this ileal mucosal cells, it get absorbed into the portal circulation, where it binds with the transcobalamin 2. And through this transcobalamin 2, it get reached to the different tissue. So this is the digestion, absorption and transport of vitamin B12. Now coming to the dietary sources. In dietary sources, it is mainly produced by the microorganisms. In the intestinal flora of the animals, that's why it is present in the food of animal origin. Food of animal origin, that is meat, fish, etc. Now, the RDA, that is recommended dietary allowance, is 1 microgram. Now coming to the biochemical functions of vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 is responsible for catalyzing the two important reactions. The first important reaction is catalyzed by the methionine synthase. In methionine synthase, this is a methyl transfer reaction in which homocysteine is converted into the methionine. And in this reaction, the methyl THF is required. Methyl tetrahydrofolate is required, which get converted into tetrahydrofolate. And for this conversion, vitamin B12 is required. So this is methyl transfer reaction, also known as homocysteine methyl transferase or methionine synthase. It is B12 and THF dependent reaction. In the deficiency of this B12, there is increased level of homocysteine, which leads to the cardiovascular manifestations. And also, if there is deficiency of B12, this THF gets trapped as methyl THF, because this is a dead end here, and there is functional deficiency of folate, and that is known as folate trap. Functional deficiency of folate, in which it gets trapped as methyl tetrahydrofolate in B12 deficiency. Coming to the second important reaction, in which it is catalyzed by methyl malonate CoA mutase. This methyl malonyl CoA mutase causes conversion of methyl malonyl coenzyme A to succinyl coenzyme A, and this succinyl coenzyme A enters the TCA cycle for complete oxidation and energy production, and also this can enter into the heme synthesis. The propionyl CoA, which is produced by the oxidation of odd chain fatty acid, is converted into methylmalonyl CoA via the propionyl CoA carboxylase, and this methylmalonyl CoA is converted into succinyl CoA with the help of this enzyme, which is B12 dependent. And the deficiency of this vitamin B12, this methylmalonyl CoA gets excreted in the urine, that is known as methylmalonic acid urea. Now coming to the deficiency symptoms and their causes. First we will discuss the causes of deficiency manifestation of vitamin B12. The first important cause for the deficiency of vitamin B12 is the vegetarian diet and nutritional deficiency. Nutritional deficiency, that is decreased dietary intake, or a person on strict vegetarian diet, there is deficiency of vitamin B12. Second, malabsorption syndrome. Third, increased demand. As in pregnancy, there is increased demand of vitamin B12. Fourth, important cause is pernicious anemia. In pernicious anemia, there is production of autoantibodies against the parietal cells. That's why there is deficiency of intrinsic factor. And due to the deficiency of intrinsic factor, there is deficiency of vitamin B12. This is another cause for deficiency of vitamin B12. Now coming to the deficiency symptoms or deficiency manifestations. The first important is megaloblastic anemia. It is due to the fact that vitamin B12 is related to the folate, and due to the folate deficiency, there is decreased DNA synthesis, and due to the decreased DNA synthesis, cell arrested in the S phase. Arrested in the cell phase and continue to grow without a cell division. That's why there is increase in the cytoplasm of the cell, that leads to the macrocytic picture or macrocytic RBCs. And there is the number of immatured RBCs are there in the circulation. Coming to the second important deficiency manifestation, that is subacute combined degeneration. This is due to the defective myelination. The first important cause for defective myelination is this methyl malonyl coenzyme A, which is generated due to deficiency of vitamin B12. It competes with the malonyl CoA and decreases the fatty acid synthesis, or inhibits the fatty acid synthesis, or inhibits the synthesis of myelin. This is the first reason. Second important reason is this methyl malonyl CoA get incorporates into the sphingolipids and glycolipids, that leads to the defective myelin synthesis. Because of these two reasons, that is inhibition of malonyl CoA and inhibition of fatty acid synthesis, there is decreased myelin synthesis, and this get in methylmalonyl CoA get incorporated into sphingo and glycolipid, and that this leads to the defective myelin synthesis that leads to the degeneration process. Coming to the third deficiency manifestation, that is there is excretion of methylmalonate in urine.